Hi, and welcome back. In this video, we'll talk in a bit more detail about Java and why we use it in this video series. First of all, Java is a purely object-oriented programming language. If you don't know or don't remember much about object-oriented programming, I recommend that you refer to the previous video. We will not go deep into the history of Java or its features, but there is one that I believe is quite important to mention, partially because explaining this feature involves explaining translation, a basic programming concept that we should be able to understand. Some of you might know that computers process data, and that all computer data is presented in the binary form, a sequence of ones and zeros. If you're not sure what this means, you got it, please refer to the previous video series to learn more about it. There is one problem though. We humans are not very good at working with long numeric sequences, consisting of ones and zeros only. In other words, we are not comfortable with the computer language, and computers don't understand our human languages. What do you do when you want to communicate something to someone who doesn't understand your language? Right, you use a translator to help you. A similar approach has been taken in programming. You create a piece of code in a language that you're somewhat comfortable with, and then that code is converted into the language that computers can understand. The language that computers understand is called machine code, and any machine code is a sequence of ones and zeros. The code that we create using programming languages such as C, Scratch, or Java is called source code. And the process of conversion of source code into machine code is called translation. So far, so good? Now, to make it a bit more complicated, we humans have invented two different types of translation, namely compilation and interpretation. Before we move on, let's take a look at some features of compiled and interpreted computer programs. When you compile source code, you create a program for a specific platform, or simply put, for a specific system, such as Windows, Mac, Linux, and so on. This is why most user programs exist in different versions for different operating systems. For example, there are separate versions of Google Chrome for Windows and Mac. Another example is games. You cannot run games created for Windows on a Mac computer, and you cannot run Xbox or PlayStation games on a Windows computer. On the other hand, you can run code written in an interpreted programming language virtually on any platform. Some of you might think that interpreted programming languages are better than compiled ones because the former are more flexible. Well, while it's true that interpreted languages allow for more flexibility compared to compiled languages, it doesn't mean that the former are superior to the latter. In fact, both types of languages have their advantages and disadvantages. One of the disadvantages of interpreted code is that it requires additional software to run. For example, if you want to open Google Chrome, which is a compiled program, you just click its icon and the program starts. However, you can't just run a Scratch program directly on your computer. Scratch programs only work inside Scratch, which is an additional software. In other words, if you write a program in a compiled language like C, compile it for, say, Windows, and send it to your friend who also has a Windows computer, your friend will be able to run your program on his or her computer without any additional software. However, if you create a program in Scratch, save it, and send it to your friend, he or she will have to open your program in Scratch to run it, which might not be very convenient. On the other hand, Scratch is available for many platforms, so it doesn't matter what kind of system your friend has as long as he or she can open Scratch on that computer. Another difference between compilation and interpretation is that compilation happens before the so-called runtime, whereas interpretation happens during or at runtime. What is runtime? It is a period of time that begins when you start a program and ends when you close the program. For example, let's look at Google Chrome. When I open it, its runtime begins. And when I close it by clicking the close button, its runtime ends. This example is not 100% accurate, but it's accurate enough to give you an idea of what runtime is. Because compilation happens before runtime, compiled programs are generally faster than their interpreted analogs. Why? Imagine making fries from potatoes, as opposed to making them from frozen potato strips. Which one do you think will take less time? Right, using the pre-processed potatoes. In other words, because compilation happens before runtime, when you start a compiled program, your computer begins executing the program right away. Alternatively, when you run interpreted code, Before the computer can execute it, it needs to do an additional step of translating the code into machine code. Now, why is this important? Normally, when you create a program, it's either compiled or interpreted, but not Java, which makes it somewhat special. A source code written in Java is first compiled into an intermediate language called bytecode, which is then interpreted at runtime into machine code. This means that to run a Java program, we need additional software that will do the interpretation. This software is called Java Virtual Machine, or JVM. While this means that you do need to have JVM installed on the computer to run a Java program, it also means that you can run the same Java program on multiple platforms, as long as there is JVM version for that platform. In fact, write once, run anywhere was Java's slogan created back in the 90s. Now let's summarize what we have covered in this video so far. The only language computers understand is machine code, a sequence of ones and zeros. Machine code is not a very human-friendly language. Programming languages like C, Scratch, or Java are more human-friendly. The code written in a programming language is called source code. Because computers don't understand source code, it needs to be converted to machine code before the computer can execute it. The process of conversion of source code to machine code is called translation. There are two types of translation, compilation and interpretation. Compilation happens before runtime, while interpretation happens at runtime. Compiled programs are platform-dependent, but generally run faster than their interpreted analogs. Interpreted programs are generally platform-independent, but require additional software to run. Java is both compiled and interpreted programming language. Java source code is compiled to bytecode and then interpreted by JVM into machine code at runtime, which makes Java programs largely platform independent. Java's flexibility, however, is not the main reason why we use it in this video series. The main reason is that Java is somewhat similar to the C language that we used in one of the previous video series, which I believe will make learning Java slightly easier. Java is also, in a way, similar to C# that we will use later on when we get to game making with Unity, which I believe will make transition to C# smoother. Some of you might ask, if we will eventually start using C#, why not do it now in this video series? The main reason is that, overall, Java is more popular than C#, at least at the moment. It is in a greater demand in the job market, and many schools use Java as the main language to teach programming. And this is it for this video. In the next one, we will go more practical and start making programs in Java. Looking forward to seeing you. Bye.